Hello everyone, and welcome to Congleton Choral Society's 50th anniversary Christmas concert. We've had a fantastic autumn getting to know our new music director, Tom Newall, and have been singing some amazing festive pieces. Sadly, due to the ongoing COVID situation in the UK, we can't bring you our concert live, but it has been our pleasure to record our concert to reconnect with our audience after a long 2 years. 50 years ago, our first concert was in fact at Christmas, and we begin with a piece we sang in that first concert, John Jubert's Torches. Originally based on a Galician carol, Torches was written for the pupils of Jubert's wife, Mary. We will then sing a carol that nods towards the excesses of the festive season, conductor Malcolm Sargent's arrangement of the Boar's Head Carol. This carol is from the 15th century and is about the tradition of sacrificing a boar and presenting its head at a Yuletide feast. Celebrating local talent is very important to us. Andrew Green is our fantastic accompanist, but aside from this, he is also a composer, and we will sing his version of Away in a Manger. Another local composer known to our choir is Bob Wysom. Our assistant music director, Ian Pickford, was a close friend of his for more than 40 years. Bob was an accomplished musician in many fields, as director of music at Telford Sixth Form College and as a freelance conductor, working with both professional and amateur orchestras in the West Midlands. Ian will conduct Bob's piece, My Dancing Day. The Russian composer Tchaikovsky is perhaps best known for his work in the world of ballet, but he has written a beautiful setting of The Crown of Roses for unaccompanied chorus. The text is based on the poem Roses and Thorns by American poet Richard Henry Stoddard. The original form of the piece was for solo voice and piano.
Bye.
We now come to the centrepiece of our programme, Cecilia McDowell's A Winter's Night. This is a piece charged with positive energy, written for chorus, brass quintet, organ and percussion. McDowell combines several popular carols in English, French, German and Latin, and puts her own stamp on them with reharmonizations and rhythmic variations. The piece ends in a jubilant finale with many of the tunes we have already heard intertwined into an impressive climax.
Thank you.
hope you'll join in at home as we sing Good King Wenceslas, the story of a Bohemian king going on a journey through the cold winter weather to donate food and money to a poor peasant on the Feast of Stephen, which today we recognise as Boxing Day. Morten Lauridsen is recognised as one of the most widely performed composers living in America today. His setting of Shore on This Shining Night brings this luminous text to life. The piece comes as part of his three nocturnes. The Sands Day Carol is based on a traditional Cornish folk song named after the village St. Day, where it was found at the beginning of the 20th century. This carol is very closely related to the more famous Holly and the Ivy.
Thank you.
British composer John Taverner wrote The Lamb in 1982, set to a text by William Blake from his collection Songs of Innocence. After this, we will then bring our Christmas concert to a close with two carols that need no introduction, and we hope you'll sing along at home. The first is O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
Many thanks for watching our Christmas concert. We can't wait to be back with our audiences again, performing on stage, but we have really enjoyed making this recording. This is a free concert, but if you would like to make a donation towards choir funds to help us to continue our work through these challenging times, there is a link below this video. We are back in the new year with Mendelssohn's Mighty Elijah, and we hope to see you then. We will finish our concert with Hark the Herald Angels Sing, and we'd all like to say Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.